Today I'm going to do the timing belt on this 2009 Honda Odyssey. Carried this engine from 2005 all the way to current model. They still have pretty much the same as this one right here. Need to drain the radiator first. Removing the crankshaft pulley. It's a 19 socket. Using the 14 socket to untension the serpentine belt. So now take out the pulley. Somehow just a little bit yank it. Need to take out this tension. And the socket here is number 12. I can see the water is leaking right there, and those little green there is water. So the water pump is right under this engine mount right here. I am removing this 214 number 14 bolt right there. It's a 14 millimeter socket. There's a little tiny bolt, 10 millimeter socket right here, which is under the power steering pump. For the timing mark on this, and you can see is one, which is one, and there's a little mark right there, straight to that, and also on the top here, I got a mark right there too, a little bit, I don't know if the camera can see that, but right there, they are not straight, but here is the mark for the cam, okay? And straight to that right there, to right here, okay, that's what it is. And down here in the rear one, and which is this right here, which is they do mark on that, and straight to the top here, got a little tiny mark up here, which is right there, okay? So I'm going to mark that, and which is this belt is not broken, so it doesn't matter what I do. As long as I keep this mark where it should, then I have no problem with the timing at all. And down here at the bottom, okay, and you can see this mark right there. And up here, which is 06M, and on top of that right there, this little tiny arrow right there, that's the mark. So I'm going to do marking right there, which my timing, and that right there, so they are straight. So now I can take out my timing belt and put the water pump in there. I'm going to remove the timing mark sensor. This is a crank sensor, basically. I'm going to move the tensioner out of the way. Removing the tensioner idler pulley, and that's the socket or open wrench number 14. So now time to take all this water pump bolt right there, right here, that one, and this one right here, okay, all of this. Just get the screwdriver and try to pry a little bit right there. And top it with a hammer. Now water is drip. Okay. It looked pretty much the same as the OE other one, and this one also doesn't say any of that Japan or Honda, but this one came from Napa. Okay, let's get in here, cleaning all the old gasket right here. Make sure it's no silicone left in here, so the seal will seal better. I put some silicone to hold the seal, the O-ring seal right here, and plus to help protect the any other leak that, you know, maybe the O-ring does not seal good enough. So now it's time to put the the water pump back in there.
You cannot make mistakes like this because they have your pin there.
this bolt kind of dirty, so I'm gonna clean with the wire brush. The reason I clean is good because you need torque on this, and they recommend about 33 foot-pound of torque this idler. It's not much at all. This is a brand new tensioner kit. I'm using this paper clip here to clip down the belt. See that right there? Helping me hold on to not let the belt go flip over on that. The second one is going right here to help me hold that. Before I release my tensioner pin right there, I have to check, make sure my mark is still there, because sometimes you don't check, the mark is already off one point, then you are screwed up on that. So the mark here is still good there. That mark is still there. So now it's time for me to release my tensioner. So that will be complete my installation. What you have to do, just pull this pin out. Now the tensioner is released. The timing is tight. So I need to turn the timing a couple of times to see if the mark is still there. And make sure the tensioner is tight all the way. So when you turn like that, it will help the tensioner work better. Okay, the mark's there, straight, and the other mark right here, also straight. That mark down there is straight to the belt. Pretty good now. So I need to put it back, the covers. So now it's time to tie everything back up. So basically just reverse whatever you taking out. All right, water, everything's add up. So let's go fire it up to see how it sounds. Hopefully it sounds good only. Sounds good. Sometimes it's very scary at this starting, because you can mess up with your engine because you didn't timing right, you know? So very scary. The water is very calm, bubble is normal because the engine just warm up.